Right. I think, again, as you say, we have considered evil primarily in terms of theodicy or our understanding of God and the classical way. And a lot of this, I think, came out of the, well, first of all, I mean, again, it's a perennial question. I said before, evil, suffering, and death are perennial questions that deal with God. There's no way you're going to avoid them. Also, though, I think it came out, especially of the Enlightenment and areas of that time, that weren't that much dealing with evil and suffering, and how do you deal with it? But then, with regard to the God question, the question came about, well, how can you possibly believe in a good and gracious God in the light of all the problems, suffering, and evil that's present in the world? And ultimately, I think the only answer you can give, which came out of Christian theodicy, was that evil doesn't come from God. Evil comes from human beings. It's our abuse of human freedom that brings about evil in the world. And therefore, the traditional way we phrased it was, God permits or allows evil. God does not will evil. God does not cause evil. Evil comes from our abuse, our sinful use of our freedom. And consequently, then, God allows it. The old biblical analogy of the wheat and the tares. The tares are the weeds that God allows the weeds to grow, kind of thing, and only at the end of time are the weeds and the tares, are the wheat and the tares separated. So I think that's the theodicy question. But in some ways, even much more important than the theodicy question is the moral question of evil. How do you live with evil? How do you live with suffering? And I mean, and that ultimately, you know, this question goes back to Job. I mean, it goes back to the beginning of humankind. But how do you deal with the issue of the evil as it affects me and with suffering? And it seems to me, again, then, that the Christian understanding can give us some help. I mean, it's ultimately a mystery. Why does X suffer and not Y? Why was I born in this country instead of being born in a country where I never could have gone to college, where I never could have studied, where I never could have had the opportunities I've had here? Why? And in the end, there are no easy answers. But I think that what we as Christians have always learned from the central reality of our faith is the Paschal mystery of Jesus. And that suffering and evil is always going to be a part of human life. Now, quite frankly, I think we rightly try to avoid suffering and evil. You know, we shouldn't go looking for it, but it's going to come. And it usually comes in the forms that we don't want, that we don't understand. And ultimately, as I say, if we see that in the light of the mystery of Jesus, that suffering and evil that came to Jesus, and the ultimate belief that evil can be transformed into good. The problem is, it's not always going to happen in this world. And that we know, I mean, I admire people, and we all know people who have gone through suffering and it's made them better persons. I mean, I think of families that have had Down syndrome children. And who'd want a Down syndrome child? But also to hear them talk about it later, to say, what good came out of this for us and our family? It made us more conscious of what human dignity is all about. It made us, again, face the most important issues. It made us recognize the most important values aren't what money can buy and what we can accomplish that way. So I think we all know people who have been able to turn suffering and evil into good. But also, you know, we know people who have been so overcome by evil that they gave up. They committed suicide. Their life was stunted, or, you know, they just went off into addictions of one type or another. So that in the end, yes, we do believe that evil can be redeemed, but we also believe it's never going to fully take place in this life. But all we do know is that Jesus suffered. If Jesus suffered, we're all going to have to suffer too. And we try to see Jesus as the model. We try to change evil into good, but we know in this life it's never going to be perfectly done, and we hope for a future life where evil is changed into good, and there's no more tyranny and no more killing and no more suffering and no more sorrow.